Your life will never be the same.
Beloved, we celebrate the goodness of the Lord that the time of our fulfillment has finally come. We've waited so long, but the Lord has visited us. I'm speaking my faith over your life. I'm speaking my faith over your ministry. I'm speaking my faith over your family. I'm speaking my faith over your career and destiny. That's the word of the Lord. It happened for Joseph, and eventually his brothers that vowed that they would never bow down to him. They did. But they did without knowing they did. And that's why your fulfillment is here. Even all the enemies and all the satanic barricades, they wouldn't even know what happened. They wouldn't even know when God moved for you. It's such a wonderful thing. And now they're home. They came on to Jacob, their father, onto the land of Canaan and told him all that befell unto them, saying, "The man who is the Lord of the land spake roughly to us and took us for spies of the country. And we said unto him, we are true men, we are no spies. We be 12 brethren, sons of our father, and one is not. And the youngest is this day with our father in the land of Canaan. And the man, the Lord of the country, said unto us, hereby shall I know that you are true men." Listen carefully, beloved. "Leave one of your brethren here with me, and take food for the famine of your households, and be gone. And bring your youngest brother unto me. Then shall I know that ye are no spies, but that ye are true men. So will I deliver you, your brother, and ye shall traffic in the land." They should have gotten a clue. They said, "Now, if you bring your youngest brother, I'm going to let Simeon go, and now you'll be free to roam in all the land of Egypt." That should have been a clue. Oh, beloved, even though they sinned, but yet God never let him go. Even though many of you have sinned, but he hasn't let you go. Even though he will bring to pass what you thought was impossible. Beloved, even though you didn't believe and you fought against it, you can see that Joseph's breakthrough is now getting ready to open the door for his own brothers. You have to know that God never gives a breakthrough to one person alone. You have to know that the breakthrough that God has given you is not just for you, but it's to save people, it's to bless people, it's to open doors everywhere for everyone. That is the power of authentic deliverance and breakthrough. I'm believing God for my next level. And there's so many people I already know whose destiny will start, who will be blessed, who God will restore their finances and restore their opportunity, their dreams, their responsibilities. They will find that God is faithful. They will find that God rewards them, that God will bless them and reward them for sticking with me. I know it, beloved. And I'm believing God to see the manifestation, even in this season. This word is for me. Even as much as it is for you. And I'll be watching it the month when this will be aired. I'm expecting something. My neck is out, beloved. Glory to God. Glory to God. And it came to pass as they emptied their sacks that, behold, every man's bundle of money was in his sack. That's when you know their breakthrough is showing up. All of a sudden, money starts coming. The money they should have spent returned to them. Isn't that wonderful? Hallelujah. You see, every man's bundle of money was in his sack, and when both they and their father saw the bundles of money, they were afraid. Woo! Say, they were afraid. What in the world is going on here? And Jacob, their father, said unto them, ooh, I thought this would come tomorrow, but here it is. I'm ending today with it. Hey! It's so powerful. Watch this. And Jacob, their father, said unto them, "Me ye have bereaved of my children. Joseph is not, and Simeon is not, and ye will take Benjamin away." All these things are against me. Ooh, I love it. All these things are against me. But beloved, all these things are working together for Jacob. And we know that all these things work together for good to them that love God. Ooh, beloved, I want to talk to you about this thing. Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on, beloved. Pain. Remember, he doesn't have information. That's why you and I heard so many times. We are not God. He didn't know Joseph was alive. He didn't know this was all the plan to bring him to his greatest breakthrough. I want to really devote time to it tomorrow. I just want to skim the top of it. All these things are against me. And yet these things are designed to bring him to his greatest breakthrough. All these things are against me. The pain is so deep. The hurt is unbearable. And it was all false. Oh, it was God. Oh, how I pray, beloved, that your heart will change. That you remember that God is on the throne. And that God is faithful. That God is able to fulfill his word. All these things are against me. Do you feel like that today? Do you even feel like the word I'm preaching doesn't apply to you because you feel so withered and so forlorn, and it's been so long since you saw a breakthrough? Many faithful believers have gotten discouraged. Many have returned to sin. Many are dying prematurely. They make the journey all the way in. Do you feel like all these things are against you? Yet, beloved, all these things are for you. For you. For you. Take that word today. What are you talking about? What pain are you talking about? What disappointments are you talking about? What failure are you talking about? All these things are for you, even though they appear to be against you. Do you have faith enough to believe it? Can you accept it? I challenge you to confront your unbelief and walk into the destiny God has promised. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you, beloved. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting.